been read, my patient's peeing well.
Three rounds, there's 15 charts to go.
Coags aren't back, sweet lab techs, hear my prayer.
Call down, sweet lab techs do not care. Forget your wife, we'll finish after one.
The work won't end, our notes all pen here past dusk.
On rounds, the questions never end.
How long will we all stand around this bed?
On rounds, the attending's word is true. On rounds, all fine knows more than you.
President with pager 24601, your time is up, your career is done. Leave and don't come back.
Have I wronged you so?
You fell asleep in Mr. Critical Page. That is not allowed.
I only missed one page.
You missed an order.
I was only 1 hour late. Her surgery was a huge success. She ate before.
And she should eat again. She had to wait an hour to eat food.
I've worked so hard for the past 4 years. A doc of Michigan.
4 years, but one mistake. Time's up, you're done with medicine. Bye, 24601.
My name is Helen Morgan.
And I'm bovine. Do not forget my name. Do not forget me. 24601.
On rounds, your career is on the line. On rounds, your soul belongs to fire.
Look at you. You're disgusting. You missed a page requesting to advance the patient's diet. Can you imagine for 1 second the patient lying there, starving every second in eternity, just waiting to trade in those ice chips for the sweet nectar of a fruit cup? I'm terminating your status as a resident at Michigan.
I only missed one page. It wasn't that big of a deal.
Everything is a big deal when it comes to patient care. You will never be a good doctor because you need to learn to put the patient first.
No! Dr. Fine, please! Please, it won't happen again, I swear! Just let me stay and help with this last patient. Please, I just want to leave here with just a shred of dignity.
The rectal foreign body?
Yeah.
You'll never get that out.
At least let me try.
Dr. Erica Newman, I'm here to help.
Perfect, because there's something stuck in there, and it's stuck real deep.
Dr. Morgan, we've all tried to remove the rectal foreign body. If you can't get it, we're going straight to the OR.
That sounds like a pain in the ass.
I can do this. Dr. Mark Cohen, this is all I have left.
Godspeed, Dr. Morgan.
Oh, almost there!
My God, I think you can do it!
I can feel it! Oh God, it's so deep! Oh no, it's turning!
Morgan, you're losing it!
Oh, here it comes!
My God, she's gonna pull this
right here!
John Figgs, have you ever seen anything like that? To remove an object that deep with her nimble hands?
She's gifted all right, Erica Newman. Damn gifted.
Wow, first aid? What do you think she was gonna do? Absorb the knowledge through rectal osmosis?
Impressive. But your dexterous hands won't save you. Thank you for the most uninteresting consult. Now get the hell out of here.
This is bull! Crap!
Dr. Richardson, Dr. DePonio, take Dr. Morgan home.
Nope. Don't resist. We'll have to break your knee.
And I'm not about to do an anterior drawer test today.
This isn't right!
You'll never work here again. I'll see to that.
What can I even do with myself now? I've worked my whole life for this. I have a bachelor's degree in pre-med. I make one mistake and now nothing.
Hi there, welcome to the career fair for people who got MDs but didn't finish medical school but still want to do something medically related. Have a muffin.
I'm not in the mood, Dr. Nelkhurst. I was destined to be a leader in OB-GYN. I had hopes and dreams of being the president of ACOG and to pay it forward and teach the doctors of tomorrow to be a great. But now look at me at a career fair.
Dr. Morgan, Brett Williams here. You ever woke up and thought to yourself, why did Jesus get to save all those people? What about me?
Well,
I know I have. Christ may have had his sheep, but we have third world orphans. We can save them. How, you might ask? Oh, that's easy. By taking a pack of undergrads on a medical mission trip and basically just hanging out, taking some pics for the gram, you know? Now, I know you might be thinking, isn't the real problem the systemic poverty preventing those countries from establishing any form of healthcare infrastructure? To that, I would say that's a bunch of malarkey. Those students' parents aren't paying you to ask questions.
Well, I hate to admit it, but I didn't exactly finish my training.
Well, you have a white coat, and technically they can call you a doctor, right? Nobody will know the difference.
Well, that sounds great, but I think my passport's expired.
Let me ask you a question. Don't you think it's wrong for rich people like us to get the same health care as poor people?
What?
Hi, I'm Dr. Kim Eagle. In order to solve this crisis, we here at Michigan have created Victor's Care, a concierge medicine program where the 1% are able to pay for the care that they deserve and widen the gap between the rich and the poor. And, you know, between me and you and Twitter, I was able to buy a new car.
That seems a little self-serving.
I'm not so sure. I mean, it was only a BMW X3. It's not like it was a Porsche or something.
I'll stick to my Prius.
Yeah, you will.
Dr. Sheets! I could really use one of your patented bear hugs at a time like this.
Oh, Helen. Don't worry about not being able to practice medicine. I've been directing the family medicine clerkship since before people hated it. And I don't even have an MD.
I guess that's a good point.
You know, Helen, the OB-GYN clerkship does need a new director. You could be just like me.
Oh, no! Bradford?
Helen, now what are you doing, running tearful through the yard?
I was working for Paul Fine, I missed one page over the night. He told me that I am finished, Michigan is done with me.
He might have told you he can do that, but this power lies with me. Helen Morgan, you're a doctor, your mistake cost no one's life. Fine is testing out his power, filling working days with strife. Helen, dear, you must keep going. You have years to provide care. I believe you have a future and a gift. Your gift is rare. But remember this, good doctor. To get up and try again.
Helen, Paul Fine cannot kick you out of residency. You are officially reinstated! Well, bye.
Okay. Am I really worth the second chance Dr. Carol Bradford is giving me to finish residency? Do I really have what it takes to be a good doctor?
If I return, I am condemned. If I don't practice, I am damned. Who am I? Am I a failure of a resident? Unable to give help to my patients? Or is there still some good in me, some worth Carol Bradford could see? Who am I? How can I keep myself from looking back? The sound of that Miss Page haunting my past. What good are my credentials for if I can't practice on the floor? Why must I let him ruin all this work I've done? How can I let him gloat as if he's won? My heart's in medicine, I know. I matched him nobly long ago. Is that a 10-day I'll start anew? Prove this is what I'm meant to do. Who am I? Who am I? Helen Morgan. I'm so profound, you'll say it's true. These nimble hands, they don't fear you. Who am I? 2, 4, 6, oh.
Excuse me, that's the part where you're supposed to clap. Let's try that again, shall we? Thank you. Oh.
Joel, they must not know who we are.
Clearly.
Let me introduce myself. I am Kate Klein, radiologist extraordinaire.
I am Joel Heidelbach, mediocre family medicine physician.
And we are your guides tonight.
Nay, your friends. Wow, Kate, look at them out there. They're a cute bunch, aren't they?
Oh, yes. Except for Dr. Mulholland out there bringing down the average. It's okay, Mike, not your fault. All right. Dr. Wong, you're blinding me with that head of yours. The lights are reflecting off of it. All right, Joel.
I think, is that you, Dr. London? Good to see you. I heard you've been having some issues with, I hope you've gotten that taken care of.
Oh, Joel, HIPAA.
Oh, sorry.
All right, show of hands, who out there has not seen Les Mis?
You gotta be honest, come on.
Come on!
Who has not seen Les Mis? Everybody has seen it? Wow. Well, you're a wonderful crowd. Very educated. Love it.
Oh, all right. Well, this is good because, I guess it doesn't matter because you don't need to know what Les Mis is about.
It's true, you don't.
Not tonight, because what we have for you today is
a story of intrigue!
Of war! Of revolution!
Of lust!
No, Joel, no lust. But speaking of stories...
Yes! Today we will not keep you here for 4 hours like Smokers Past. Oh. Talking about you, Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever Horror Picture Show.
Yeah, it's a travesty. Anyway, isn't the next scene, the one with the branch director's jewel?
Oh, yes, that's a great scene. I quite like that scene.
Oh, shit. Aren't we in that one?
Ooh. Yes, we are.
Signing up to be branch directors was pretty stupid. Mama's gonna need some juice to get through this.
I agree. Let's make this meeting quick. I've got patients in clinic to see, and those prostates are not going to finger themselves, if you know what I mean.
Oh, come on. All right, ta-ta!
Shall we?
We shall.
All right, people, take your seats, take your seats. Everyone's seated? Everyone sit down? Okay, good. Crazy world out there. The curriculum's changed. There's a lot of space to be filled, and we are moving, people. Dr. David Hughes, what do you got?
Good morning, Dr. Inglesby. Thanks for having us. Morning, everyone. So, Mike, I want to update you on this branch design project you proposed. Students now have more time than ever to make an impact in the medical field through multiple areas of concentration. As you all recall, I was named Procedures-Based Care Branch Director.
Procedures-Based Care. PBC. PBC Dave! All right, who's next? Dr. Kevin Gregg, hit me with some gold.
Sir, as director of the systems-based and hospital-based practice branch, I really do have to ask, why branches?
Trees are life, Dr. Kevin Gregg. Trees are life, and we live in the heart of life. Ann Arbor, Tree Town!
We think students will really love this idea because it truly enriches their medical school experience.
That's good stuff, Dr. Brittany Allen. Oh, hey, what's that you got there?
It's my lunch from Jerusalem Garden.
Oh, you got that JG. Slide it on over here and give old Mikey a taste. Mmm, that is good stuff. Pita!
Boring!
Oh, tell me about it. Thank goodness you froze them.
You can imagine how anything gets done around here. Mike's a nice guy and all, but he has the attention span of an 8-year-old waiting on his next dose of Adderall.
Oh my gosh, is that House of Cards? We're doing House of Cards now. Everybody please give her a round of applause. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. All right, Kate, let's get this thing moving, okay?
Yes, come on.
Okay. What were we talking about?
Well, Dr. Inglesby, we were trying to come up with a more concrete plan for what the students will actually be doing during the branches.
PBC Dave strikes again. All right, let's lock it in. Dr. Kevin Gregg?
Well, with all of this extra time, students will certainly be able to get more research publications on their resumes, even if they're just to, you know, MJM.
Mm. More papers, higher ranking, and they're at a top medical school, you know. The top!
Sir, we're ranked number 15 now. You actually have to click next page to see us.
Next page! Next page! This is a crisis, people! Code red, code red. We're bleeding out here. PBC Dave, I need you on this. I need 10 units of packed PBCs.
Okay. Sure. Dr. Inglesby, doesn't sound like we're gonna be doing much teaching during the branches. Should we even charge tuition?
You know, I envisioned this year as a, what do you call it? YOLO scenario. They will pay us $50,000, and in return, they'll like take online classes and get wine drunk and watch The Office or something.
Ugh, Kate, I know that you and I are branch directors, but I don't think we care about this any more than all of you out there do. What do you say we get this meeting over with and get the heck out of here, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yes, let's keep this moving. Ugh, Joel, you moron! You have to hold it by the shaft!
All right. Wellness is important too, you know. I don't know if you've seen the residents, but they are not happy. Not happy at all. Maybe they do need a lighter schedule before resident. Oh, hey! Joel Heidelbaugh, my main man. Oh, Kate Klein, the one and only. I've been waiting for you two. Come on.
We were just about
to. We're going to leave.
No, I'm pretty sure I'm your boss.
We may be leaving this meeting, but we're not leaving all of you.
Until we see you all again.
Ta-ta!
It's a scut work life for us. It's a scut work life for us.
Instead of treating,
we get tricked.
Instead of feedback,
get C-diff. It's a scut work life. Got my MD months ago. Now the scut life really blows.
Stupid pages,
instead of codes,
EMR notes,
same white coats. It's a scut work life.
We make less than minimum wage.
Don't it seem like we never see sunlight?
Med students, how they fill me with outrage.
My children don't recognize me at night.
No one cares when your patient is sexist and creepy. No one's there if you float or if you sink. No one helps when the wounds get wet and weepy.
After work, I'm gonna need a hard mixed drink. Life, endless rounding life, cutting suture life, where's the future life?
Attendings we never see.
Attendings, what's that? Who's he?
Medicine you will resent when you are a resident. It's a scut work life.
Advance my diet today, or so help me God, I am leaving A.M.A.
Take the edge out your nose, shove a Foley up your hole, make her drink a set of dose. I love you, my chart. It's a scut work life for us.
Instead of closing,
we retract.
Instead of learning,
disimpact. It's a scut work life.
No problem. I don't know how to sleep. My patient's piece always on the go. I'm learning how to treat my feet of Pete. Just check my dance goals. But hustle's still inside of me. Despite all this anxiety, this back and forth and riding got me checking my goal. Now what do we want? What do we want? How about solutions? Don't leave me on. Cause dog, if we on, might spark a revolution. All in this institution. So get your scrub straight. It's scut life, but we're about to elevate.
It's a scut work life for us. It's a scut work life for us.
Was really catchy and all, but is our life really that bad? We sound like a bunch of angsty teens.
You just don't understand, Dr. Sinal Owens. Nobody here understands our pain except for Annie and My Chemical Romance.
Oh, wow, Dr. Dave Stewart. You might want to up that Lexapro dose, big guy. I don't think you're in the therapeutic range.
Come on, Dr. Nick Theoni. I know you're an ultrasound expert, but you don't need an ultrasound to know how broken we are on the inside.
Yeah, Dr. Jen Stojan, I knew I'd have to make sacrifices for residency, but I didn't know I'd have to miss so much. My sister's wedding,
my son's first steps. You want to hear something even worse, Dr. Elizabeth Jones? I was on call last year and I had to miss the M1 bar crawl. You know, you all know how clutch that is for scoping out the new talent.
Yeah, if it gets any worse, I'm gonna have to consult Dr. Belmonte in psych and see if they got any room for me. Stat.
Well, at least we have the work hour restrictions, right, Dr. Amir Ghaffari? I mean, we work, what, like 11 and a half hours a day?
You know, you're right, Dr. Madeline Liu. 80 hours a week isn't that bad. I can handle 11 and a half a day with a weekend to recharge.
No, no, that's if you work every day. If you want weekends off, you're looking at a cool 16 plus the 80 hours a week is the average across the month. So really, you could work way more if you do the math.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow your roll, Rain, man.
What was that?
Oh, shit.
Can you imagine what it would be like if we didn't have those work hour restrictions? I mean, thank God we have that silver lining.
Listen to yourselves. All the hard work, all the late nights. The reason that we even need these work hour restrictions shows a sickness in our profession.
Well, hey, Dr. Steve Gay, at least the hospital feeds us. We get free lunch. Look, there are bagels right there.
Let me see those. What do we have here? Plain? 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 Where's the diversity? There's nothing but plain bagels here. Okay, okay. We got a couple sesame, a couple cinnamon, one jalapeno cheddar, and wow, there's only half a pumpernickel bagel in here?
I mean, Carol and I always put in for a few more pumpernickel bagels, but they just don't end up in the box.
That's a damn shame.
I understand, but think about it. When they bring that Jerusalem garden in, boy, that JG is the highlight of my week. Ain't that right, Dr. Wawong?
I forgot about J Garden. You're right. Maybe things aren't that bad after all.
Yeah.
It's not enough.
What do you mean, Dr. Kanjivaram?
I mean the food. It's not enough.
The hummus is pretty good, though.
Yeah, but she got a point, man.
We can't be expected to live off of Jerusalem garden coming once a week. What happens when the falafel well runs dry?
Hari is right. We're asked to work on godly hours, sacrifice the best years of our lives, give ourselves to others, but at what point do we leave some for ourselves?
Thank you, Steve. I knew as a fellow person of color you'd feel me.
I mean, technically, but not really.
No. No, you know, Steve, come on, you know, like, I'm Indian, you're African-American.
One more time. Let's try one more time.
All right. African-American.
Black.
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 Okay, just...
Attention. I have a letter from the Office of the Bad Guys addressed to all residents.
Effective immediately, there'll be no more free lunch, free bagels, free JG, or free food of any kind. What the fuck?
Are you serious?
I can't believe this. Can they do that?
What's going on?
What's going on?
Are you serious?
This isn't right. We need to do something.
Yeah!
No, what we need is a leader.
Yeah, exactly.
We need someone with charisma, with a powerful voice and an effortless smile. Definitely.
Whose very presence is a reminder of how great we all are, how great we're all meant to be. Someone who can breathe life into this movement.
Yes, exactly.
All right, I accept.
We met Steve.
We'll take the bogey.
All right, guys. Yeah.
Thank you kindly, Dr. Ghaffari. We work an insane number of hours. We're not paid very well. And now we can't even have a measly shawarma? Listen up, we should revolt. This scuttwork life we must end soon. We're burning out here left and right.
Revolt, you say? I agree. To save the lives of you and me, we can't go down without a fight.
I need to sleep, I need to rest. Can this be how we do our best? Exhausted, numb, no place to go. To make the admin understand the work our day to day demands, the system we must overthrow.
Yes, my friends, I agree that our lives kinda suck.
But can we abandon our patients in their greatest need? My friends, I must ask, what's the price they might pay? We are the backbone, if not us, then who?
If we only care for them, then who will care for you?
Maze of fear that shakes my core, when a babe cannot breathe air.
Maze,
the urine on the floor, the cold when we're not there. It is time for us all to decide who we are. Did we work all these years just to live in the hospital now? Fair and me, oh my friend, above all you should know that our patients come first. We need to move ahead. We have to act as one for something to be done.
Maze
that it drops and left unbound.
Blue,
the pill that stands us right.
Maze,
the light that must be found.
Blue, the charge to do. I'll fight with you and join the cause, for now there is a higher call. Then stand with me to take a chance, for if our aims are to advance, our protest will be for us all.
Maze, the color that brings us pride. Blue, the feeling that's disappeared. Maze, our forces unified.
Century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it. Screams from the haters. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. Stop tripping. I'm tripping off the power.
Yeah.
Like a boom, 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 boom.
Mary Sisson, and fuck Oringer.
Oh, Rachel, Oringer?
I don't know, Nathan. I just have a feeling that Oringer guy's a freak.
Dan or Mark?
Ooh, Stevie J. They both sound yummy.
Guys, guys! Oh my, whoa, SJ grew. Oh, I was up late writing my doctorate essay last night, and I didn't wake up to any of my alarms, I didn't check on any of my patients, and I just got here.
Dr. Fine's gonna tear you apart, Christina.
Oh, I know, Galena. I get a nauseous thinking about, oh, here he comes.
I know any JAMA has a higher impact factor, but I really feel like JAMA's tackling the important issues.
Oh my God, med student, you prefer JAMA too? Tell me, what are the clinical implications of last month's meta-analysis of the Partners 2A trial on transcatheter aortic valves? Perhaps you can enlighten your colleagues since you're so familiar with the literature. That's what I thought. Oh, it's a beautiful day for rounding, students. Let's get this show on the road. All right, first patient belonging to pager 55345. Ah, a med student pager. Give it to me straight, subjective, objective, and whatever refuse you've managed to scrap together into an assessment and plan. What's going on with the patient?
Wait, Dr. Fine, didn't this patient
Excuse me, I was talking to the medical student.
Um,
Yes, Ms. Curtis, I assume you want to know how she did overnight. I mean, of course you want to know how she did overnight, because I was definitely on time and I totally saw her. And this morning I went into her room and it was really nice. We had a little chat. It was real good.
If I wanted to wait this long for someone to get to the point, I would have asked Dr. John Williams how his day was going. Tell me, what was her physical exam?
Oh, physical exam, of course. Alert. Oriented, heart rate, regular, rhythm.
Regular rate and rhythm like this? Beep, beep, beep.
Yes, that was it, yes.
Are you sure it wasn't more like beep?
Wait, what?
Looks like you missed the memo, 55345. Unfortunately, she is no longer with us. Dead. Deceased. Pushing up daisies. Cashed in her chips. Gone to a better place where she's no longer being taken care of by you. Get out of here. 5, 4.
Wait,
3.
What?
Oh, I'm not counting time. This is your clinical grade plummeting. 3, 2. All right, next. Next patient, 17574. You're up.
Why is he calling Dr. Erin McKean 17574?
Oh, that's her pager number? I don't think he knows her real name.
Mr. Jackoff, Jackman, is a 58-year-old male who was admitted 3 days ago for TIA, initially presented with right-sided weakness and numbness, which has since resolved, planning for discharge today.
Med student, what was his physical exam?
His physical exam was hard to do because he was busy.
What does that mean?
You know, like, busy.
What is that? Dupuytren's contracture?
No. Not that. The patient was engaging in some self-care.
I see. Fascinating.
Oh, no. Cut the reenactment scene. We cut the reenactment scene. Judith, shield your eyes.
He's getting hot. Don't finish. I'm sorry we didn't get anything useful, Dr. Fine.
You're giving up this easily? There's always something useful in the physical exam, no matter how useless the examiner. Did you at least notice what hand he was using?
His left.
And what was his reported-handedness?
He's right-handed, sir.
Interesting. Right-handed man using his left.
Erin, are you okay?
I think so. Okay. I'll be fine.
TIA. Resolved right-sided weakness and numbness, and now, apparently, switch hitting.
Switch hitting?
Yeah, switch hitting, you know, like being the master of your own domain, but with the other hand.
Med student, tell me, do you ever switch hit?
No, sir. It's pretty hard to cross the finish line with the old lefty.
Exactly! Get this man a head CT.
What?
Really? Why?
Put it all together, students. No sane right-handed man would use his left by choice. TIA, resolved right-sided weakness and numbness, and now apparently using his left hand for just a moment of comfort, which can only mean right-sided paralysis. It's clear that this man has had a stroke.
Shit! Oh,
this guy's a genius.
We need to get Neuro involved. You, go call Neuro.
Guys, I'm not okay.
I need help over here.
What is it? Where's the pain? I don't know what that means. Use your words.
Yeah, she's getting worse.
It's mildly renowned gastroenterologist Dr. Andrew Tai. Thank God.
Hello.
We have a 28-year-old woman over here with sudden onset abdominal pain. We need your help.
Large gush of water in a premenopausal woman? Doesn't sound like a GI problem to me. Might want to call OB.
Obstetrics? Does he think I'm pregnant? How is that possible?
Well, when a man and a woman love each other very, very much.
What?
Could you be so full term without realizing?
You didn't notice that you were missing your periods?
figured I hadn't been having my periods because of the stress of residency.
You weren't curious about all the unexpected and very noticeable weight gain you've had?
I mean, I basically had to live here. I haven't exactly had time to do groceries and eat healthy. I figured I've been gaining weight because of all of those huge, warm chocolate chip cookies at the cafeteria.
This is how bad it's gotten around here, people. Some of us don't even know we're pregnant.
Let's get OB in here.
Pacey, OB on call. They're on their way. Hang on, Erin.
Clear the way, everyone. All right, Dr. Kempner, give me the rundown.
All right, Dr. Morgan. Mother is Erin McKean, G1P0. Was an I didn't know I was pregnant situation, so we don't know how far into term she is.
Okay, you and you, what do we have for access? Let's get 2 large bore IVs in her now.
What's the RH status?
Good call. Send off prenatal lab stat. Hi, Erin. I'm Dr. Helen Morgan. This is my chief resident, Dr. Sam Kempner.
You're going to be okay.
What are the vitals?
Her vitals are stable. We've hung a bag of Valar and placed her on tachometry.
Okay, let's get in there and see what's going on. Erin, do you mind if our medical student does the digital exam?
What?
Whatever. Do whatever.
Me? Sure. Hello. I am a medical student. I am gonna touch you now. I am gonna introduce me to your touch. Stupid! I'm gonna stick my hand in your vagina now.
Okay, we don't have time for this. Let me do it. She appears to be 10 and plus 2. Oh no.
What? What do you mean, oh no?
I feel feet.
Oh, she's in breach. We gotta do something immediately.
Pushing tocolytics.
Oh, Sam, this baby's coming right now. We don't have time to do a C-section. We're gonna deliver the baby breech.
What? Breech? You're gonna try to deliver the baby feet first?
I'm sorry, I can't find this in blueprints. Is this gonna be on the shelf?
It's okay, Erin. Dr. Morgan can handle anything.
Keep pushing, Erin. You're doing great.
Oh no, I'm seeing D-cells. The fetus is in distress.
I can do this.
Almost there! Oh no, it's turning! Sam, I need some supraphilic pressure!
Baby girl.
Oh, Dr. Morgan, I can't thank you enough.
Very impressive, Dr. Morgan. Pleased to meet you. I'm Dr. Paul Fine.
Nice to meet you as well.
Dr. Morgan, are you okay? You look like you just saw a ghost.
Sam, there's some things you don't know about me. I have a dark past.
What? Who are you talking to?
I didn't think that I would see him again! But here we are. I can't believe he didn't recognize me immediately.
You know, Dr. Morgan, I can't say I've ever seen someone deliver a breech birth before. You have very nimble hands. I've only met one other doctor with hands like that. But she left the university long ago. Or so I had thought. Tell me, have we met before?
I don't think so. We should be going, Sam.
Stop! Med student. What was Dr. Morgan's pager number?
24601.
No! It can't be! What are you doing here, 24601?
Carol Bradford gave me another day, another destiny. She gave me hope when hope was gone. She gave me strength to carry on.
That one who missed a page, how can it be?
I've gone on to do great things as annual B.
I kicked you out, but now you're faculty.
Paul Fine, please move on, it was years ago. We're equals now.
You behave disgracefully, you must be gone.
There's IUDs to place, I will press on.
Hello, everyone. I'd like to call to order this inaugural meeting of the bad guys. What's that stand for again?
Raj, thanks for asking, Justin. The bad guys is the board addressing delinquent, guilty, unpersevering young trainees.
What? That is such a good name. Did you come up with that? Guys, let's all clap for Raj. That is such a great name. Okay, let's get a roll call started, see who showed up. Start with surgery, of course. Justin Dimick. Hey, that's me. Present.
Okay, Rishi ready? Present.
Jill Cherry, present.
Cliff Craig. Present!
All right, this meeting's already running behind. Why don't we just do hands? Dr. Michelle Daniel, Dr. Raj Margokar, Dr. Jonathan Trobe, Dr. Seetha Monrad, Dr. Michael Horsch, Dr. Maya Hamoud.
Present!
Love the enthusiasm, Dr. Hamoud. Love it. Dr. Paul Fine. Dr. Fine. Paul's not here. Bummer. All right. First things first, everyone. Discussing whether or not we want to axe Therapause.
Huh? Raj's flaws? What?
No. He said Therapause. You know, the service dogs that go around to the residents and occasionally for the needy med students for stress relief.
Was? That exists here? They should, the dogs, move downstairs to Dr. Bartlett's lab. They use the whole animal to be much more humane.
If I may, I know that Dr. Horsch is often known as a fun guy. But these animals could track in mycoses that could endanger our patients.
Thanks so much for that, Dr. Carol Kaufman. I guess they're kind of cute, but I kind of want to just get rid of them. Okay, all in favor of axing Therapause?
Aye.
Axed! Love it. All right. Next up, too many students are getting honors and clerkships. Dr. Michelle Daniel, you're going to fix this?
Thank you, Dr. Dimick. I've done some market research. Apparently 25 or even 30% of the students are getting honors.
What? That is outrageous. There is no goddamn way that 30% of these students are honor students.
You know, at least we're not as bad as those jackasses at Harvard. You know, last I heard, they were giving 90% of their students honors, and some of them even highest honors, and they got rid of Pats.
They justify it because they claim that every Harvard student is an honor student at any other medical school.
Is that true? Seriously?
Yeah.
Kind of a dick move, huh?
Definitely a dick move, Justin. Oh, sorry, guys. Definitely a dick move, Justin!
According to my estimates, only 5% of the students truly deserve honors.
And half of them can't even get a full in without contaminating themselves.
And 40% of them read every single lab value when all I want is a fucking creatinine.
And honestly, another 5% of them just sort of look funny.
Yeah, okay. Well, I guess that leaves us with about 5% who deserve honors. Okay, all in favor of 5%?
Aye.
The honor students have been axed. Now we're cooking. All right. The ACGME wants us to get some feedback from the residents about what it's like to work here. Dr. Seetha Monrad, you're on this.
I've compiled. I've compiled the responses. Seems like the residents are wanting more wellness.
Oh God, not this again.
Yeah, you know, we send out a lot of surveys and we get a lot of feedback, but you know as well as I do that we don't actually do anything with it. I mean, we send the surveys and we analyze it, but we don't do anything with the feedback, actually. Anybody can collect it. But I guess this is why we maybe are having the same problem again and again.
You know, there sure are a lot of complaints about us getting rid of the free food. Oh, here's one that's different. I've worked 110 hours this week in the hospital, which is 30 more than the ACGME limit.
Is that a complaint, though, or are they thanking us for 30 extra hours of learning opportunity?
When I was a resident in the 60s, we worked 48-hour calls, high on acid, pumped on uppers.
Is complaining about not having enough time to be meaningfully involved in their child's life.
Get a nanny.
And there's more. Here, take a look, Dr. Dimick.
You say work takes up time, there's no room for the fun things in life. You cry in your scrub, said you can't go to clubs, no Rick's Necto or Live. Why so sad? You eagerly matched into residency way back when. Now you're making demands. You may say we're cruel and we're heartless. That's our plan. You complain, but we don't care. Residency's not meant to be fair. You complain, say you're scarred, but we told you this was gonna be hard. Boners rise, old folks fall. We made differentials for it all. And when you say you're done, I'll add 20 clinic hours each work week. Oh my gosh, isn't this fun? Da 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 da. Doctor, depression is growing. You blame it on me. Sick of your pleas, your pleas. 'Cause you're the hospital's residence. The hospital is your residence. My sweet and lowly residence. My humble, inferior residence. For 4 years, and 5 years, and for some of you, 6, 7, or 8 years. Put in the time, do your work. I don't care about your concerns. Talk to the nurse, print the list. These are all the tests that I don't miss. We need you, and you need us. Come now, don't I'll be so treasonous. Just one thing to get you through. That one day you'll have some residents to boss around for you. La da 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 da, la da 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 ya da, la da 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 ya da, la da 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 da, la da 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 ya da, la da da. Everybody, la da da da.
Wunderbar. So it sounds like the residents, sure, complaining a lot. But what can we do?
I mean, since we're talking about wellness, I guess we could give them a gym?
I could hold weekly office hours and pretend to listen to their concerns.
I guess we could give them the free food back.
Yeah, we could give them the free food back and all that other stuff everyone else suggested. Or we could hard pivot, strip the work hour restrictions, and lean into this whole bad guys thing.
I couldn't agree more, Dr. Dimick. These work hour restrictions are ruining learning opportunities.
Absolutely, Carol. You think Dr. Oringer would have realized he could fit his hand through that tiny hole in the diaphragm if he hadn't been alone in the OR at 3 a.m.?
I guess that's true. Okay, well, then, all in favor of stripping the 80-hour work week restrictions?
Aye.
Okay, the work hour restrictions have been axed. All right, everyone, we're done here. Who's up for some JG?
Wait!
Hey, Paul. Hey, everyone. Paul's here.
Hi, Paul.
Todd, what's up, buddy?
Sorry I'm late. I was dealing with a personal matter. What did I miss?
Who knows? Did anyone take minutes?
Well, I guess the main things are no more Terrahunde, no more honors, und ja, no more work hours.
Oh, yeah. Now that I think about it, that whole work hour restriction thing might grind some gears.
Don't worry about that. I'll rally the troops and take care of it. I'm out for blood today.
Dr. Morgan, what the hell is going on with you and Paul Fine? And why are we hiding in the supply closet?
Shh! Keep your voice down. Dr. Morgan, what are we hiding from?
He won't stop until he ruins my career, Sam. I made one mistake, but that was years ago.
What are you talking about, Dr. Morgan? You're the best attending I've ever worked with.
Oh, Sam, I'm so happy to have you by my side. Mentoring young, bright trainees like you, you remind me why I'm so lucky to be doing what I'm doing.
Everything I knew to be right now seems wrong. Dr. Morgan, the delinquent, the deviant, she continues to practice medicine. How am I to sleep? To eat? To live with a quiet mind when a walking violation of the Hippocratic Oath stands tall in these hallowed halls of Michigan medicine. I will not stand for this. I cannot allow this to be. Do I seem obsessive? Perhaps. Am I manifesting a potentially crippling Cluster C personality disorder? Perseverating on details that others would consider trivialities? Quite possibly. Could I break free of this obsession with Dr. Morgan with some solid CBT and an SSRI? Many would posit yes. Or, am I exhibiting a staunch dedication to what is right, what is just?
I'm really frustrated and angry right now. I do my least favorite thing. We've got to break some bad news to the residents.
Shit. They're already overworked and underpaid.
Don't know if these snowflakes can take it.
But I don't want to do it. I make people happy.
Oh, Joel, you're such a baby. Fine. Why don't you have one of them do it?
That's a great idea. Who out there wants to break some bad news to the residents?
Hmm.
Anybody?
Oh, you're all a bunch of wusses like Joel. Come on.
Come on, one volunteer, somebody, maybe from the patron area, some of you doctors up here who have done this before. Anybody?
We know it's
any
not
psychiatrists
your first time.
In the front few rows here who are very good at breaking. You know, I see you, sir, with the glasses right there. Yes, you. Do you mind standing up? Please, everyone, give him a round of applause. Would you please come to the front of the stage?
All right,
people.
There's just something about you. You look like you're great at disappointing people. You know what I mean? Like.
Oh, perfect.
Welcome, welcome.
Yes, okay. Yoo-hoo, disgruntled residents!
Dr. Klein? Dr. Heidelbaugh? What are you doing here?
We're here to give a message to the Damn, is that you, Dr. Glick? You look ravishing.
Yes. You look as young as your daughter.
Folks, that is her daughter.
Okay, never mind that. Precious, read this for us.
From the Office of the Bad Guys. Effective immediately, there will no longer be an 80-hour workweek restriction. In fact, there'll be no restriction at all. You all will work as long and as hard as your attending demands.
This is some funked up bullshit.
Like
they cannot
I've been
take
saying.
Away our work hour restrictions, I'm sorry.
Oh, like I've been saying, Steve, we have to fight this.
Yeah.
I will find her. Dr. Morgan will face retribution.
I won't let him bring me down. There's more to medicine than doing everything by the book. Dr. Fine just doesn't know that, yet.
There are a lot of people here. Pretty exciting stuff.
We put so much into our jobs every week. Has anybody thought about how much time 80 hours really is?
Yeah, 80 hours. What is that, like 288,000
seconds? 288,000
seconds
a work week. 288,000 stories we hear. 288,000 seconds a work week. How many pages can we get in a year?
At midnight, they paid you with diets and DC Foley. You should answer with a smile for the patients we serve.
288,000 seconds a work week. When can we go home and have a life? The call we take.
Not the way we should learn how to do what is right.
Audience participation here for a very critical role. You, sir, in the blue shirt and the tie, yes, you, would you please just stand up for me? Yes, you. Everyone, give him a round of applause. Are you ready? I will tell you exactly what to do, okay? Are you ready? Welcome, monsieur. Sit yourself down. Time to resume the best show in town. Your time's so scarce, a night off each week. Thanks for coming here for our tongue in cheek. Trust me, you won't find such open, honest minds to share and give with care opinions unrefined. Doctors at you, Mish.
Academic powers.
Practicing perfection from their ivory towers. Order lots of tests.
No one gives a damn.
Do we really need these thorough exams?
Doctors think they're quite important. Working for a noble cause.
But noble gets you nothing. We just want your money and applause. Doctors at you, Mish.
Specialty obsessed.
Need more than PCPs to be the leaders and best. Plastic surgery.
Serving vanity.
Fall asleep with haze and you'll wake up with D's. Everybody loves a skin doc, but acne causes lots of strife. But if you're on a plane choking on romaine, don't expect a cream to save your life. Doctors at you, Mish, think they're so well read. Will JAMA really help you know this guy is dead? Healers of the sick, listeners of pleas, caretakers of empathy who cure disease. Medicine is a great profession, but doctorships are very proud.
What a bunch of bullshit! Hey, at least we have a decent crowd. Joel?
Yes, Kate?
Did you know that before I settled on radiology, I wanted to be a family medicine doctor like you?
Wow, I had no idea!
I used to dream that I would see patients. Thank God that I've come to my senses since. Clinic every day, make me want to cry. Leave me in the dark to read my MRIs. I would be talking to patients, pretending to care. Checking on my bank account, there's not much there. What a cush life I live now, with a mansion just around the block. God knows how he's lasted working as a family med doc.
Doctors at you, Mish.
Load of riffraff.
Caretakers with empathy.
Hey, don't make me laugh.
Healers of the sick. Listeners of please.
Bunch of type A gunners, not my cup of tea.
Thank you all for coming out here. We hope that you're all having fun. Get ready for the second act.
Woo! Show us you know how to laugh.
Woo! Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
So
feels so good to be back in front of you all.
For the stage.
Oh, my goodness.
Recapitulate,
yes,
shall we?
Yes, yes, yes.
That grumpy bastard, Paul Vine, was pretty upset to see that Helen Morgan still roaming the halls of the hospital.
Yes, he was pretty pissed off when she missed that page.
Mm. And did you see Erin, McKean and that baby? Who knew that surgeons could have children and see them?
Ooh. And what about the resident strike? Will the bad guys meet them in the middle? What's going to happen? Who knows? Oh, so exciting!
Oh, don't talk to me about those snowflakes. They're always whining. You have to handle them with gloves! Blah, 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 blah.
Kate, we've said enough. Mm. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Ta-ta!
Sam, you seem distracted during rounds this morning. I hope all this stuff between me and Dr. Fine isn't getting to you.
No, no, it's not that. It's just, I've been hearing a lot about this resident uprising, and I don't know, I think they may have some good points.
Sam, I know your wellness is important and everything, but it gets better. A little. Just keep your head down a little while longer and you'll pull through. I know it. If anyone can pull it off, it's you.
But I don't want to just pull through or pull it off or pull out.
Well, no one said you had to pull out.
Sam, what if they fail? Then what? No matter what, no matter how noble your cause, you'll still be the doctor who broke the rules.
I broke a rule. Once. Trust me.
don't want that. I can't lose you.
Okay, Dr. Morgan, you're right. Thank you. I love you, Mom.
What?
What? I'm sorry, Mom. Oh, God, I said it again.
Hey, it's okay, Sam. We're gonna be okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna go get some shawarma from JG. Do you want anything?
That's okay. I'll catch up with you later.
All right, I'll see you in a bit. Right.
I know Dr. Morgan wants me to play it safe. Getting involved with this revolution could be risky. I mean, they don't even know what they're fighting for. Wellness and other stuff? What does that even mean? But I guess it couldn't hurt to at least go check it out.
Dr. Cinti, nice to see you. What's your name again? Random white guy. Nice to see you. Jonathan Half. Always good to see you. Laura Mariani, always good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Adrian, girl, come in here. How are you?
Thank you.
Girl, you look good. You know, black don't crack, girl. You know, black don't crack. Excuse me. Kelly Sullivan. Oh, excuse me. Catherine Kim. All right, thank you. Oh, shit, is that Fitz? Oh, damn. Dr. Lucayla, I mean, it's just you look like this M4 hottie Fitz.
Oh, that's all good, man. Bring it in, bring it in. You know, I'm just trying to get like you, though.
Bro, I'm trying to be like you.
No, I'm really trying to get
Dr.
like
Luke,
you,
Dr. Lucayla, I'm really trying to get like you.
Okay.
You feel me?
I feel you.
Okay. One second.
That's my wife.
Girl, come on in here. How are you? I want you to make sure you're at the barbecue this year, but leave that nasty-ass potato salad at home. Hurry. Just get your ass up here and let's get started. All right.
Lean in.
Settle down. Shit, hold on. I might have to step off stage and go get some water. I'm about to give a fire-ass speech, so give me 2 seconds. I'll be right back.
You know why we are here.
Mm-hmm.
The bad guys have decided to make an 80-hour work week go bye, bye, bye.
Oh, come on now.
Now you know, and I know, what it's doing to us.
Mm-hmm.
It's killing us.
Mm-hmm.
Softly, with their words. Now look, we're gonna get it back. We're gonna do something about it. Because I know they're not ready for this jelly.
You better preach now.
But it's important to understand something. I need you all in on this. I need you all in on this because I don't want no scrubs.
Steve, are you just dropping lyrics from 90 songs for inspiration?
Seriously, I have no idea what you're talking about. Now look, in order to get this done, in order to be where we need to be, understand, they don't want us to have this.
Mm-hmm.
They don't think they need this, that we need this. Yeah. But what we are going to have to do is look them right in the eye and tell them, I want it that way.
Water break took me a little long, but I'm back now. We all know that something is not right with the way we are made to work here. Even though we may not want to admit it, we have been fooling ourselves with the realities around us.
Come on.
Open now. Your eyes, people.
We start each day like any other. We come in, we round, we see a few patients, and we beg for it to be over. Because we know in our hearts that we'll be here till 8 p.m. and have to be back here at 5 a.m. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
We live in the midst of inhumanity.
Yeah.
Of injustice.
Yeah.
And if any one of you out there agrees with me, I said if any one of you out there agrees with me, I want you to stand up on your feet, wave your hands like this, and stand up and testify.
Hi, I'm Sam Kempner from OB-GYN.
Dr. Kempner's new to the movement, so once again, let's welcome Sam.
Residents, Erin McKean. Residency has been so hard on her. She went 9 months without realizing she was pregnant and then gave birth while rounding.
Sam, you have witnessed
the miracle of life.
Sam, you have witnessed an abomination. One of our very own carrying a child that she did not even know about, blinded to the symptoms of pregnancy by the trials and tribulations of this martyrdom we call residency. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Dr. Thayuti, you look fired up. What's inside of you? What's stirring? Come up and testify, brother. Dr. Thayuti, come on now.
Hi, Nick Thayuni from Emergency. Well, they make us work shifts that are all over the place. First days, then nights, then days again. Oh. No consistency. My sleep schedule's a mess.
Well, you better speak, Dr. Thayuni. You better speak.
Yeah! I demand more regularity for the 12 shifts I have every month.
Come on.
Get your ass off stage.
Man, I think it's that bad.
Would there be another? Come on. Come on, brother.
Jonathan Haft, CT Surgery.
Yeah.
I just want to say, thanks for providing this environment where we can speak our minds openly. As a CT surgeon, we're discouraged from sharing our feelings with others, or letting each other know when we're down, or honestly, having feelings at all. But sometimes I have a hard time, too, and I just don't know what to do.
Yeah, brother.
Great.
Should've
joined Psych? Yes.
Stop being a bitch.
Now, while Brother Hav did know what he was getting himself into with CT surgery,
yes. We
all have made mistakes.
Yes.
Like the curriculum, I agree. Would there be another to come up and testify tonight? Would there be? Sister. Yes. Sister with the good casserole, come on.
Hi there, I'm Jennifer Lukella, Chief Resident in Internal Medicine. And I show up every morning on the service at 5 a.m.
And that's 2 days early! Yeah.
I get there early, basically do all the work. Then the attending shows up, rounds for 2 hours, leaves and expects us to stay all night long.
Ridiculous.
These same damn attendings that show up round till noon and have their chief residents take over so they can go home, these same damn residents that don't want to do any damn work. Sit your hypocritical ass down. No matter what we thought, all of the money and wealth we get will not keep us sane.
No.
All of the awards and accolades we get will not keep us sane.
No.
All of the prestige and that feeling of superiority we get when we tell others that we are doctors will not keep us sane.
No.
Preach! Boy, I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, reverends, people from all specialties, we must come together to right the wrongs around us. We must fight for our wellness. Yeah! Brother Hari, what's on your mind?
Steve, these are all good points. We're all fired up. Obviously something's wrong, but what's the right thing to do? I'm just having a hard time keeping all this straight. Sometimes I wish that I could just snap my fingers and turn into an older, wiser version of myself and just have all the answers.
Wow. This really worked. Damn, I aged well. I'm much wiser now, much older. I'm supposed to know all the answers for everything. Mm-hmm. Everyone is upset. Yeah. You all want change. Yeah. Now let's see. I think we should have a revolution or something. Sounds really fun, but I'm getting too old for this.
Wow, can't believe that worked. Didn't really help at all. I still don't know, what's the right thing to do? Becoming a doctor is what my life's been about. So what happened? Did well on the MCAT, so D.O. school was out. But what happened? When I finally became a doctor with an embroidered long white coat, I thought I'll at last be important and sign my very own notes. I thought I would have a chance to connect with folks heart to heart. Instead, I stare at my computer, checking boxes on my chart. $500,000 in debt. What's so scary about that? We must remember our vow to serve others and know that we have each other's backs. I must accept the training throughout and trust that it'll all work out. As MDs, treating patients is our privilege. As MDs, working 28-hour shifts helps them get better. And as MDs, we prevent nosocomial infections wearing super thin yellow gowns. I am a doctor, and medicine is for me. The job won't always be easy. We have to be prepped for it all. From the guy who craves oxycodone to the kid with twisted balls. I can't allow myself to have any doubt. My specificities must be high. Time to show patients what congebum's about and save some people's lives. As MDs, cutting someone open is an honor. As MDs, part of that honor means holding your pee for 12 whole hours. Not giving lactated ringers is the equivalent of medical malpractice. I am a doctor, and by gosh, medicine is for me. And now I can feel the excitement. Treating patients is what I'm meant to do. But even if the job is meaningful, work-life balance must be improved. Our residents say that we're underpaid for the hours we slave away. But we're so close to a better life and that sweet attending pay. As MDs, wearing scrubs all day is real comfy. As MDs, taking board exams our whole lives is super fun. And as MDs, we know that anyone presenting with dramatic weight loss and kyphosis has gotta have full-blown AIDS.
Full-blown AIDS.
I am a doctor, and dang it, medicine's for me. I'm an MD.
Steven Harrier
right. We all got into this to take care of patients.
But Dr. Stojan, how can we do that now, with these hours, under these conditions?
We have to take the next action, people. We must march into a new era.
Oh. Oh, shit. My bad, Dr. O.
I meant to say, we will not stand for this. Can't say that either. Man, all these inspirational quotes all involve standing. Whoa! Damn, Dr. O, that was some Transformer-ass shit.
Damn it, Dr. Gaffari. I've told you don't have to say things differently just because I have a disability. You all have heard me say that disability doesn't mean inability. People with disabilities can do whatever they want. We can be med students, we can be doctors. Just check out our article coming out in the New Medicine at Michigan Magazine. I hear it has a bomb-ass cover picture. We can even stand up just like you.
My bad. I'm just sitting up here. I was trying to have this whole inspirational moment saying that we wouldn't stand for this, and now you're standing? You know, the whole quote's supposed to be a metaphor, so you don't actually have to stand. Oh. But it is pretty cool that you're doing that, bro.
Enough! Thank you kindly, Dr. Gaffari. Tonight, we turn off our pagers and we see how this hospital functions without us.
Turn off our pagers.
Who's with me?
You just turn off the pager.
I'm in.
Wait, what?
Yeah, me too.
Wait, we doing this?
Let's do this!
Okay.
Yeah! Let's do this!
Turn these pagers off!
Hari, we have to do more. With these pages, they keep us chained tighter to the hospital than Christian Grey's nipples in a sports bra. These pieces of plastic have kept us on a leash. Tonight, we destroy these damn pages.
Okay, hold up. We've destroyed the pagers, but now what? They know where we are. They'll find us. What's to keep them from coming in here and forcing us to go back to work?
She got a point.
Didn't think about that.
That's not good.
We will build a barricade. We will block ourselves in, like med students hiding in the call room so they can't get to us. Without residents doing all their scut, they'll see what we've been through. Tonight, we strike!
Yeah!
Strike! I dreamed a dream of tide for joy, when tone was high with no prolapsing. Would be forgiving when I looked between my thighs. My introitus burst asunder. When I cry,
make things better. A Frankenstein they've made of me. Innocent vibes now joined together.
So I brought you some Jerusalem garden. Sam? That's weird. Sam's never been late before. Let me page her. Hello. Hi, has Dr. Sam Kempner come on yet today? She hasn't. Okay, well, I guess let me know if you see her. Still doesn't page me back. Sam always answers pages immediately. Maybe the paging system is down? No. Much as I'd love to believe that that HITS major incident email this morning was actually important. This smells fishier than bacterial vaginosis. Sam? Oh, sorry, I thought this was... What? Dr. Matt Wixon? Dr. Christina Gallagher? They haven't come in yet today either? Oh, okay. Oh my goodness, she must have joined the uprising! Sam, you bastard! You son of a bitch! How could you do this to me? I loved you. This is a disaster! A catastrophe! A tragedy!
All right, everybody, this is where shit gets real.
Look at how far we've come. We've barricaded ourselves in on floor 2.5.
But why?
Because we're not leaving or going back to work until they agree to reinstate the 80-hour work week.
Yeah! Wait, so to fight for our wellness, we're trapping ourselves in this small, sweaty room with no food or sustenance?
Well...
Yeah, where's the bathroom?
Ooh, I actually think we barricaded that one in.
Oh.
Well, we have the bucket set up in the corner right here. It's tipped over right now, but we'll get it up and running soon enough.
Good on you, Dr. Sona Owens, being resourceful. We got the people!
Yeah!
We got the power!
Yeah!
And you better believe we got the buckets.
Give me that bucket!
No.
Sam! Sam!
Someone's coming. Who's over there? State your business.
It's Dr. Helen Morgan. I'm looking for Dr. Sam Kempner.
Well, this is a highly secured area. I need to see some identification.
Dr. LaKelle, we know her from Mott.
Yeah, she's an attending.
She's a spy. Where's your flu shot sticker?
Flu shot! Holy shit, what happened to you three? Dr. Clanny, Dr. Burroughs, Dr. Schmidt? It's only been 8 hours!
8 hours of total anarchy!
It's a dog-eat-dog world out there, Lucella!
And what's on your face? Oh, God, you stole finger paint from the Child Life supply closet? There's some kid on dialysis out there waiting for paint that will never come!
Uh-oh. Hello, let me in!
Yeah!
Wait, is that Dr. Morgan? Let her in, please! I know her, she's on our side.
Listen, I'm so glad you're okay. I paged you, and when you didn't page me back, I got so scared.
It's okay. I'm sorry, Dr. Morgan. We turned all of our pagers off. I'm with the cause now.
Oh, Sam, how I wish you'd stayed on the beaten path.
I strayed off the beaten path. Once.
and I was made to pay the price by a soulless, heartless physician.
All right, residents, we know that you're in there, and while we attendings usually limit our interactions to you to as little as possible, we're here to negotiate the terms of surrender.
Fun's over, turds! I'd ax you all and take care of your patients myself, just to prove to you all that you're insignificant cogs in this great machine of medicine.
Go home, Fine!
Yes, Fine!
Settle down now. But, unfortunately, the bad guys have sent me to get you back. All right, negotiation team, you're up. Dr. Brad Dyke, you ready?
All right, residents. We're here to negotiate and end the strike.
Not gonna happen, Dr. Dyke.
Yeah! What do I do? They're resisting.
I don't know, Dr. Dyke. I'm worried. You think we can pull this off?
Relax, Dr. Deborah Thompson. They want to get back to work. They just don't know it yet.
Thank God you're here, Dr. Gelb. Have you been briefed?
No. Give it to me.
Well, we've got about 20 folks holed up down there, mostly residents. There were some medical students here before, but they all left after asking if there was anything else they could do.
And it looks like NOB attending.
NOB attending?
Fine, back down. We got this. Okay. This is Doug Gelb. Yeah. This is what's going to happen. You're going to put down your whining and come out with your willingness to work more hours up.
Yeah, Gelb.
Oh no, not you, Don Coleman. Who else is with you? Dr. Ann Cameron, Dr. Paul Sederna, are you lost? I expected this week's shift from the psychiatrist, obviously the PM&R docs, but the surgeons, I'm disgusted.
You're the worst.
I'll take it from here, Dr. Hirsch Romano. All right, listen up, residents. We've got the place surrounded. There's nowhere you can go.
Yeah, Gelb, that's kind of the point of a barricade.
Do you even have a brain?
Right. You know, Dr. Regenbogen, you're making it really easy for me to localize a pain in my ass. Okay. Well, if you don't get back to work, our SWAT team is going to come down there and force you out. No. No, they won't. But you can imagine how cool it would be if they could.
Bye-bye.
When you need results and nothing's getting done, it's time to get the counselors involved.
Said no one ever.
Oh, very funny. It's Amy and Eric. And Don and Tyrone.
It's Tyrone!
Yeah, whatever. We're going to try to meet you in the middle. Let's table this whole work hour hoopla for a second. What else do you all want?
What do you want?
Dr. Hafez, can I call you Khaled?
Khaled.
Yeah, I think I got it. I think that sounds like a great idea. We can work with that.
Let's go.
Oh, I guess we can't actually work with that.
Oh my God, you counselors can't do anything.
What about this though? What if we reinstate Therapause?
Got rid of Therapause?
We're so sorry, Dr. Solberg. We didn't know. We all loved Finnegan.
Animals. You heartless pigs!
What about yoga? What if we give you free yoga classes?
Yoga's lame!
It's too damn hot.
All right, shut up, you little shits! You have no respect! I will destroy you for disparaging our wellness events! We work so hard for this, literally 3 hours of work per day. And this is the thanks we get?
What's his problem?
Yeah, dude, come on, get down, fucking baby.
Sam, I'm so sorry I didn't hear you before. The administration clearly doesn't care about your wellness like I thought they did.
Paul, these residents are really getting on my last nerve. Do we have the pagers prepped? If we can't force them out, we can smoke them back to work with the guilt of not answering the pages of patients in need.
Load the cannons! Wait, Dr. Morgan, you can't hide from me!
Dr. Fun, what are you doing?
Someone, grab him! Wait! Can Meg Wolf and I do a primary survey on him first, just to make sure it's nothing emergent?
Check his ABCs.
And obviously, rectal tone.
Yeah.
We need a surgeon's insight. Dr. Dave Machado, what do you think?
All right, let's get a fast exam, let's get a couple x-rays, let's get a CT, get an MRI. Always see research rectal tone, come on. And let's get a PET scan, could be cancer. You know what, screw it. Let's get this man to the OR stat, right now.
Wait, what's going on? Wait, I thought we were on strike.
Yeah, I'm not lifting a finger until our demands for more humane work hours are met.
Yes, exactly, Amy Rosinski. I mean, you all know this man, and when has he ever cared about any of you as people?
Never. He embodies everything that is wrong with the system. Tie him up!
Tie him up!
Okay. So we've got him tied up.
Mm-hmm.
What do we do now?
I don't know if they're going to give in.
So we hold ourselves in here
for nothing?
Oh, what is that? Oh, are they throwing pagers at us? What are they trying to do? Remind us that we have responsibilities and people depending on us?
Whoa. Oh my God. This one says a patient is requesting an enema from his favorite nurse.
This one just says please advise and nothing else.
Classic.
Wait, guys, this one's a little more serious. Patient with abnormal EKG, call back. This one's serious too. I'm kind of worried.
You at the barricade, listen to this. The patients around you all lie in their bed. Don't you feel bad for what you've done? Patients need your care.
Wait, I'm worried about my patient. Please just let me answer this one thing.
No! No, it's a trap. Do we really believe these are real pages? They're trying to mess with our heads.
But what if someone really is coding? We can't expect faculty to perform CPR on their own. Oh. Can you imagine Scott Gatlin doing chest compressions? Oh. We'd end up with two resuscitations on our hands.
These pages are real, and patients are left up to the care of attendings alone. Only God knows what will happen to them. Lord, help us. I couldn't live with myself if anything happened to these patients. Everyone, I think we got carried away. There are people depending on us. Yeah! What were we thinking? Leaving the attendings to run this hospital? It's not like any of them know how to use my chart. I'm pretty sure Dr. Shea still uses his AOL email account.
But what about the work hour restrictions? What are we supposed to do? Just give in and take 100-plus-hour work week?
Jennifer, we made an oath to the patients, or at least respecting one in a drunken haze in med school graduation or something like that, but the patients come first.
So what? We're just gonna go to the bad guys and tell them that they won?
We just have to trust that if we do the right thing, it'll all work out.
Speaking of patients who need us, we've had one with us this whole time.
You're right, Sam. I'm proud of you. Despite his flaws, Dr. Fine deserves the best care we can give.
We got so carried away with the movement. Look at us. We tied up one of our very own.
Dr. Fine, you're obviously hurt. Let me help you.
No! I won't accept care from you. No one should. And let this be a lesson to all of you. We suffer so that our patients don't have to. Something you people obviously don't understand.
But we don't have to suffer until that we can take care of our patients. In fact, we can't take good care of our patients unless we take good care of ourselves first. Yeah. Dr. Fine, we're all on the same team here. I want to work with you to nurse you back to health. So tell me, what brings you in today?
What brings me in? I was looking for you. I jumped off the barricade and fell. You saw it happen. Is this what you call a good history?
It sounds like you're frustrated.
Well, wouldn't you be frustrated if you fell off a barricade and your nemesis was asking you these stupid, ignorant questions?
That helps me understand how you were feeling. That would be frustrating. So, tell me more about the pain you're experiencing.
I jumped off a huge barricade, broke my wrist. Oh! My Harvard ring. It's gone. I can't remember the last time I was without it.
Sounds like this ring is very important to you.
I don't know who I am without it.
I will contact social work to help you find your ring.
That's the first half-decent thing you've said in years.
Thank you. So, tell me, is anything else bothering you today? Any nausea, vomiting, chest pain?
Well, now that you mention it, my chest does kind of hurt.
Can you tell me more about what you mean when you say that?
Well, I felt it before.
Tell me more about what you mean when you say that?
No. Were you going to ask me about my family?
Is there any history of heart disease in your family?
You know, no one's ever asked me about my family before. I'm touched.
Have you ever had a stress test?
You know, I had a pretty normal childhood, I'd say. Dinners with the family at 6, occasional trip to McDonald's after a piano recital. Dad was a doctor, Mom was a pianist. I wanted to follow in both their footsteps. But when the critics hated my first two CDs, Fine Tuning and Doctor's Notes, available on Spotify, I knew that only one of those dreams could come true. So I threw myself into being an attending, hoping to earn what every attending most hopes to earn, a realistic portrayal in the smoker.
Well, life doesn't always turn out the way we plan. I mean, had it not been for your harsh condemnation of me, I never would have found my true calling and the happy life I live now. Are you happy?
Of course I'm not happy. I broke my wrist in a blind rage. Everyone's afraid of me or thinks I'm an asshole.
An asshole.
You do. You really do.
Who am I kidding? I am an asshole. You're the first person who's treated me with kindness, made me rethink the way I'm living my life.
Now, you know what? There's someone I have to go find and forgive. Myself.
Dr. Fine, don't be so hard on yourself. Here, let me. You know, a fine man once told me that in order to be a great doctor, you have to put the patient first.
Dr. Morgan, you've truly made me feel cared for. You truly are a great doctor. And all of you, I finally understand what you meant. You said that things work out when you do the right thing. And you're right. Tomorrow I'm gonna go with you to the bad guys and tell them that you deserve a healthy place to learn and work.
Yes!
Yes! Yes!
Thank you, Dr. Fine. Thank you. I feel good about what we've done here tonight.
I feel good too. For the first time in a long time, actually.
Live in my wards, I'll be your mentor. Just pay me back with 10,000 hours. That's the old way. You followed my rules, but now I see we are all doctors. We share one goal, to help patients heal. Working together, it shows we care. So it's time, and I'll trust in you. Oh, I think they meant it when they said learners need rest. Now I know patients benefit when doctors feel their best. Save lives. Something you young ones must lead,
So through these 10,000 hours,
sad and from
through these 10,000 hours,
slept 1 hour only,
through these 10,000 hours,
do what makes you inspired,
10,000 hours,
when you're worn out and tired.
Don't do this, don't do this.
I have to do this, Joel. Joel and I are quite sad because we only have...
one more scene.
Another scene, another legacy.
Ah. Oh, man, it sure does seem as though things are cooling off between the residents and the bad guys, doesn't it, Kate?
Ugh, tell me about it. I was counting on the rebellion to get me out of this branch director gig. I was planning on an early retirement.
As was I. But... now that we actually have to be branch directors, does that mean we need to figure out what the branches are? Will there be twigs involved?
Twigs?
Berries?
Berries?
Nuts?
Squirrels? No, Joel, you moron. Never mind that. Mom's gonna go show off her house.
I mean mansion to some ones. We'll leave you all to figure out how the show ends.
Yes, unfortunately, our time as your host has come to an end. You've been a wonderful crowd.
One more shift.
One more page. One scene more. Of the show.
Okay, so we're all in agreement then? Replace Big Bird and Mott with a Grim Reaper statue? Perfect. All in favor?
Aye.
Big Bird is axed.
Yeah.
Guys, this whole resident strike is really bumming me out.
Well, what if we get the med students to do all the work instead of the residents?
Jonathan, we never taught them to do anything. They'd never make it.
That is because I never made a second look app for clinical medicine. The others are on Google Play and iTunes.
What about the pre-meds? Cliff, we haven't heard from you in a while. What do you think?
Glad you asked, Raj. When I was a boy, volunteering before medical school, I did a whole X-lap. Just me and Dr. Osler through each step of his cocaine chamber.
Right. Not sure that one's gonna work again, buddy.
You know, last I heard, the residents even turned their pagers off.
Apparently, Dr. Gitlin had a heart attack trying to resuscitate a patient.
Wow. Sounds like the attendings are having a tough time out there.
Dr. Dimick, we need to put the work hour restrictions back. We need the residents in the hospital.
If we have to. All right, all those in favor of putting work hour restrictions back in place?
Aye.
The work hour restrictions have been unaxed.
Well, I guess now the neurosurgery residents can violate them covertly, just like the ACGME intended.
Wait, what's gonna keep this from happening again?
Yeah, we're gonna need to do something to make them think we care about them. Lull them into a false sense of security.
Okay, yeah, we can come up with something. Yeah, I'm stumped. Anyone got anything?
No, but it's gotta be something that is total BS. Really minimal effort on our part, please.
Mm. Yeah, something that sounds way better than it actually is.
You know what? I've got an idea. Feel like you've been seen, oh yeah.
That was a pretty cool song. Okay, Wellness Week it is. I think they'll buy that.
Wait, wait!
Oh, hey, Paul. It's been a little bit. Hey, everyone. Paul's here.
Hey, Paul, are you still down for those pedicures tomorrow?
Not now. Look. Listen, guys, I'm not sure axing the work hour restrictions was the right move. Just hear the residents out.
We started the strike because we're overworked, undersupported, and just beaten down. Well, we still are, but we gotta take care of these patients.
Guys, we kinda already sorted this out.
Yeah, we put the work hour restrictions back in place. And to say we're sorry, we're giving you a wellness week.
Wellness week, great.
So please don't ever do this again.
Yeah, please, come on, guys. That really bummed us out.
Well, regardless of how that turned out, I'm glad we stick together. You know what, Hari? You're right. People like us gotta stick together. No, no, no. Come on, do it right. Yeah. Hari, you are a clueless mother trucker. But you all right?
Gosh, guys, that is so cute. That is just great. All right, everyone, that's a wrap.
Paul?
Helen. So, you probably hate me, right? I've been really hard on you. I'd ask for your forgiveness, but I've never been really good at that.
It's okay. All along, I knew there was some good in you.
I knew there was good in you, too. Like, since really recently.
Well, despite the qualifier, I appreciate that.
I'm proud to work alongside you.
Michigan medicine is where I want to be.